Hello, my wonderful people. How are you all doing today? I hope you're good. Welcome to Early Years Matters TV. Today, I'm going to be talking about holistic development in early years, okay? So I'm going to be talking about holistic development, okay? So I'm going to be giving a definition of holistic development, and I'll be giving few activities that either if you're a parent, guidance or teachers could use to support children's holistic development, okay? So what is holistic development? Holistic development simply means looking at the wholeness of the child, okay? So what do I mean by the wholeness of the child? It means looking at the physical, intellectual, language, emotional, social, and the cultural aspects of the child, okay? So holistic development means taking a wholeness approach, looking at the overall development of the child, okay? So I'll start from the physical development, okay? So physical development, we have two forms of physical development. We have fine motor skills and gross motor skills, okay? So when we talk about fine motor skills, it means the child being able to use their fingertips, okay? So, and gross motor skills is the ability of the child being able to use their whole body, okay? So physical development is in two forms, fine and gross motor skills. Fine motor skills, the child being able to use their fingertips. Gross motor skills, the child being able to use their own body, okay? So that's physical development. So intellectual or cognitive development. Intellectual or cognitive development simply means the ability of the child being able to process things, being able to use their brain, being able to use their imaginations, okay? So that's intellectual or cognitive development, okay? So that's, I'll go to language development, okay? So language development is the ability of the child being able to use words, the ability of the child being able to use their facial expressions, either by smiling, laughing, you know. So that's language development, the ability of the child being able to use words, being able to communicate with adults, whether the parents or the guidance or teachers or people in their community or their peers, and also the facial expressions of the child, the non-verbal expression of the child. So that's language development, okay? So emotional development is the ability of the child being able to express their feelings, okay? So whether they are happy, whether they are angry, whether they are sad, that's the emotional development, okay? So I'm moving on to social development. So social development is the ability of the child being to interact with people around them, the ability of the child being able to interact with the environment, okay, either with the adults, whether the parents, guidance or teachers, their peers, their siblings, okay, so that's social development. So I'll move on to cultural development, which a lot of people often leave behind because we're in the 21st century, and it is really important that we consider the cultural development of the child, okay? So the cultural development is the ability of the child to be able to learn in relation to diversity, to be able to acknowledge diversity that it exists, okay? So holistic development has the acronyms, okay? So I use the acronym PILESC, okay? So it's PILESC, okay? So it's P for physical, I for intellectual, L for language, E for emotional, S for social, and C for the cultural aspect of the child, okay? So I'm just going to be giving you tips of the few activities that you could use to promote this development in children, okay? So especially from birth to 6 years, it is really important. Like I said, a lot of things happen from birth to 6 years, and anything that happened from birth to 6 years, it tends to go a long way throughout the lifespan of the child, okay? So it is really important, whether you're an adult, you know, adult, whether you're a parent, guidance or a teacher of young children and beyond, it is really important that you help them to support their holistic development, okay? So in terms of physical development, how can you support this, okay? So it could be simple things as, you know, letting children use their fingertips, you know, let them pick books, You know, when they pick books, they are using their fingertips. Let them flip the pages of the book around, okay? Let them feel the texture of the book. It's going to help them in terms of their physical development. Let them pick up balls, you know, when they throw a ball, you know. Simple thing as even tidying up, you know, they're using their fingertips, okay? So that's going to help young children to develop their physical development, okay? And in terms of their whole body, it could be simple thing as kicking ball, you know, running around. So when young children run around, they're using their body, okay? So in terms of their intellectual or cognitive development, okay, so ask children questions, you know, prompt their curiosity. Give them opportunity to also ask you questions as well. Give them opportunity to express, you know, to use their imaginations, okay? So that's the intellectual or cognitive development. So the language, the ability of the child to be able to use words, you know, facial expressions, it could be simple things as, you know, reading books, you know, engage them in conversation. That will encourage this group of children to be able to use words, okay? So emotions as well, let them express their feelings. If they are happy, you know, give children opportunity to be able to express themselves. It could be simple thing as, you know, storytelling. You can ask them at the end, did they enjoy the story? You know, they're going to smile if they enjoy it, you know. So that's in terms of supporting children emotional development, social development. Engage children in interactive activities, okay? So let children be able to interact with adults, okay? Let them interact with their peers. Let them interact with things around them. Simple thing as, let them experience nature. Let them interact with nature, okay? So that would help children in relation to social development. And then in terms of cultural development, talk about diversity, okay? Engage children in conversation, and it starts from back to 6 years, okay? So let them know a lot about diversity. It could be simple thing as getting the maps of the world. You can use this to teach children about diversity, okay? So you let them experience diversity. It's going to help them in terms of their, you know, like cultural development as well. Let them to be able to know that differences exist, okay, and talk about this with children, and it starts from young, okay? So these are the few tips or activities that you could use to support children's holistic development, okay? So it's really important in relation to starting from birth to 6 years, early childhood, that you support children's holistic development. One thing I'm going to advise adults, whether you're a parent or teachers or you're a guidance, it is really important that you focus on the holistic development of the child, not one path, okay? Because we're talking about the honest approach, okay? Looking at the holistic development of the child, taking an honest approach, okay? So it is really important, okay, that you focus on the overall development of the child, okay? So thank you for watching and listening, and I'll see you next time in the next episode. Take care and mind yourself. Bye bye.